Paying for the sins of your ancestors. The law is being applied by Yah. This is what I'm saying. I'm saying that no matter how you try to avoid it, the laws are being applied by the Most High. He spoke it. It's his laws. Therefore, it's his judgments. He's the judge. You break the law, you pay the price. Well, Christ paid this price for my sins. Yes, he did. But the consequences on earth, not eternal consequences, that's paid for. That's on the cross, nailed to the cross. But the consequences, and look, and I'm going to prove it to you, is still for you to pay. It's still for you to pay. Now, you can't just say that, Yakuba. I don't believe that. Okay, stick with me. So many Christians believe that because their sins are forgiven because of their faith in Christ, that they do not have to pay the price for the sins and the sins of their ancestors. The violation of Yah's laws still has consequences. So when you break a law, there are still consequences. If you're drunk driving and you hit somebody, and if the person does not want to file any grievances against you, you still gonna have to pay some price. You gonna have to pay some health bills. You know what I'm saying? That person still got to get his leg fixed. He still, you know, you still got a price to pay. That's just the law of the universe. You broke it, you fix it. You steal it, you return it. Hey, can we say, can somebody whisper reparations? So many have allowed Christian doctrine to overshadow Yah's word. Not only are there consequences for your own sins, but there are consequences for your ancestors' sins you may have to pay. Thinking that you may be willing to reap the reward for your own sins does not negate your offspring from reaping the rewards for your sins as well. So the fact that you sin, you know you got to reap for that, right? But the sins of your ancestors, you don't think you have to reap, but you will reap. Think of this. Some people think, you know, hey, my ancestors did all the dirt. They didn't enslave them Israelites. They didn't made them slaves. They didn't did all of these evil things to them. And so now we lived off of the backs of the Israelites. They didn't build our houses, built our wealth. And we keep doing things to them, but, you know, I'm not doing it. So therefore, it's not me. I don't have to deal with that. So because it's under the blood. But you still got to pay for it. See, the way the law works is there's laws at stake. And we're going to talk about this, about why you got to pay. So think about it. Your ancestor was the evil, evil, evil. You know what? Right? Your ancestor was the evil, 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 evil. You know what? But because he's dead, he's dealing with his consequences, but you reap the benefits. Because he's dead, you get to live in our land that you stole from us. Because he's dead, you get to live in our house that you stole from us. Because he's dead, you get to eat our food from our garden that he stole from us, but you ain't do nothing. And you ain't got to give it back. But you know that your ancestor then stole all this stuff. But you ain't got to do nothing. You ain't got to give reparation to the one that your ancestors harmed because it wasn't you. It wasn't me. I have nothing to do with it. God not going to judge me for this. It was my ancestors that hung y'all from trees. God not going to judge me for this. The law, Deuteronomy 5:9, you shall not bow down to them or worship them, for I, Yahuwah, your Elohim, am a jealous Elohim, punishing the children for the sins of the parents to the third and fourth generation of those who hate me. I don't hate. I really don't. I don't hate you Israelites. I don't hate y'all. But your ancestors did. Punishing the children. That don't apply. That's Old Testament, Yacob, but that's Old Testament. We don't follow the Old Testament no more. Punishing the children for the sins of the parents to the third and fourth generation. Well, that don't apply to me, Yacoba. The law is done away with. See, that's how y'all get away with it, right? You say the law is done away with, but it's not. Y'all been lied to. Come on, family. The law is what? Forever. Without laws, there's no kingdom. We're not under the law. What does that mean? We've discussed this 100 times already. We're not under the law. That doesn't mean there's no law. We're not under the law. Whereby we got to adhere to every jot and tittle that our imperfected flesh cannot keep, because you were guilty. Even if you didn't know that you broke the law, you were guilty. Now there's grace, but I'm not going into a law teaching, so to speak. But see, grace allows your imperfections to not weigh you down. The Most High looks at your heart and your intent, but the law is still there. Yes, the law is not egregious. The law is a light unto my path. I would not have known that I should not do this or that unless it was for the law. So you gotta have the law. Why? The law brings order. The law brings structure. This is how civilization is run. This is how kingdoms are run. If you don't have no law, you have no kingdoms. You have no rules. The Christians didn't lie to y'all. They lied to us. We all used to be Christians too. Believe me, do your own research. Seek the Most High. The Christians didn't lie to y'all. Oh yes, Yeshua is God in human flesh. I believe that. He's the only way to the Father. I believe that. But obedience. See, the Most High is following his laws. He's following his word. It has not changed. It has not been done away with. Sins of our ancestors. Jeremiah 16, 10 and 11. When you tell these people all this, talking about the Israelites, right? When you tell the Israelites all this and they ask you, why has Yahuwah decreed such a great disaster against us? What wrong have we done? What sin have we committed against Yahuwah our Elohim? Then say to them, it is because your ancestors forsook me. Who? Your ancestors. Why? Because the sins of the parents are going on the children to what? The third and fourth generation. Now let's assume a generation is 100 years. That's 400 years. Come on now. Then say to them, it is because your ancestors forsook me, declares Yahuwah, and followed other gods and served them and worshiped them. They forsook me and did not keep what? My law. That's why we in captivity now. Oh, y'all not in captivity anymore, Yacoba. Y'all been set free. Don't you know that? No, we're still under captivity. Because why? Y'all still rule over us. Y'all still give us laws, right, that we got to obey. If we don't, y'all going to put us in jail or y'all going to put us in the grave. I'm just saying. We still held captive. We not in our land. Y'all didn't bring us back. Y'all didn't restore us. We didn't get reparations according to the word. Y'all going to do that. But we went into captivity because of the sins of our ancestors. Well, you're cool, but that's y'all. That ain't us. So let me get this straight. Not only did your ancestors worship other gods, don't get it twisted. Y'all know y'all some devil worshipers, a lot of y'all. I ain't talking about everyone. Y'all some devil worshipers, most of y'all. Whether you know it or not, because you don't obey his word, Yeshua's word, a lot of y'all devil worshipers, y'all done killed, y'all done stealed, and y'all done destroyed. Y'all done went into people's homes, went into their land, destroyed their homes, hung them from trees, wiped out, gave them blankets with smallpox. I'm just saying, y'all done gave them some lollipops. I'm just saying, y'all done used some nukes on some people, but no, ain't nothing wrong with y'all. It's just us. You think the Most High gonna judge his chosen and not judge you all? That's what he says. That's in the word. If you don't know it, go look at it for yourself. If he did this to his chosen, what you think he gonna do to you? See, some people don't understand the Most High. Some people say, you know, I wouldn't even follow a God like that. He's a vengeful God. I wouldn't follow a God like that. He didn't told him go in there and wipe out every man, woman, and child. I wouldn't follow. That's what some of y'all say, but y'all don't understand. He knows the end from the beginning. He know the devil then put some seed out there. He know that if the wicked keep living, they're going to build cities. And if they build cities, they're going to continue to oppress and kill and destroy everybody. What did Satan come to do but to kill, steal, and to destroy? I know y'all don't like this. I know it's hard. But guess what? Y'all out of time. I'm telling you, y'all out of time trying to help y'all. Because they didn't lie to y'all. They didn't told you you don't have to pay for the sins of your ancestors. But you do, just like we did. Laws of inheritance, Hebrews 7, 9 through 10. And so to speak, through Abraham, even Levi, who received tithes, paid tithes, for he was still in the loins of his father when Melchizedek met him. So there's some blessings as well that you inherit. There's some blessings as well that you inherit because of the works of your ancestors. See, you ain't got a problem with that. You ain't got a problem with the fact that you might inherit the blessings for paying tithes. But there's also curses that you inherit. Can we say Deuteronomy 28 for the Israelites? So you don't just inherit blessings. You inherit blessings when you do good. You inherit blessings when you live righteous, but you inherit curses when you do bad. I know you don't believe me. Proverbs 13:22, this verse states, a good person leaves an inheritance for their children's children, but a sinner's wealth is stored up for the righteous. It emphasizes the importance of leaving a legacy and inheritance for future generations. Proverbs 15:25. Yahuwah tears down the house of the proud, but he sets the widow's boundary stones in place. This verse indicates that God may disrupt or bring judgment upon the homes or inheritance of the wicked. Proverbs 28:8, whoever increases wealth by taking interest or profit from the poor amasses it for another who will be kind to the poor. This verse implies that ill-gotten wealth, especially at the expense of the poor, may ultimately benefit someone else who is kind to the poor. But guess what? You ain't got to pay no price, right? You just get to live off of the fruits of your what? Only the good fruits? The fruits of your ancestors. You ain't got a problem with that, right? You ain't got a problem inheriting the land, inheriting the wealth, the money, right? You ain't got a problem with those legacies, right? But you got a problem when you got to inherit the evils. I'm just trying to help you out. I'm telling y'all. Y'all think I be hating. I'm not. But it's okay to inherit the blessing. You ain't got a problem with that. Abraham, even Levi, who received tithes, paid tithes, for he was still in his loins. That's you know what that says? That says he inherited that genetically. He was still in the loins of his father when Melchizedek met him. That means he inherited it genetically. Come on now. Repeat after me. That means he inherited that blessing genetically. What do you think the wicked inherit? What do you think the wicked inherit? All them curses and judgments piled up what? For the day of judgment and slaughter. They heap wealth for what? The last days. They didn't know that they were like animals to be slaughtered. Because all the wickedness their ancestors have done. Y'all don't believe me. I know I'm not finished. You still ain't gonna believe me. That's cool. You ain't got no time left. You ain't gotta listen. You ain't got no time left. The law, Isaiah 60:14. The children of your oppressors will come bowing before you. All who despise you will bow down at your feet and will call you the city of Yahuwah, Zion of the Holy One of Israel. So let me ask you a question, Gentile. Who's the oppressors? Who's the oppressor? Who did all this evil to God's people? Who put them into captivity? Who sent them around the world as slaves? I'm just asking, go read your Bible. I'm not making nothing up. Who's the oppressor? And if we know who the oppressor is, who's the children of the oppressor? Come on. Come on. Who's the children of the oppressor? Trying to help somebody. So y'all don't want to pay no reparations. Y'all don't want to send us back home. But y'all ain't got no more time. I'm telling you, y'all ain't got no more time. No, you ain't got no more time. Y'all better repent, and repentance is more. Repentance is more than saying I'm sorry, like the queen and the king and queen of the Netherlands. You sorry don't mean nothing. Sorry don't mean nothing unless it's applied with restoration. You got to send us back home. You got to give us the money you took. And that's just the beginning. Because guess what? Some of y'all going to have to be working out some of that sweat out in them fields. Some of y'all going to be sold to them Sabaeans. That's Bible. I'm not making it up. I told you. I'm not hating on you. See, y'all think it's hate when people trying to help you. Y'all think it's hate when people trying to help you. I'm trying to help you. They've been lying to you. They've been lying to us, thinking you ain't got to pay no price for the sins of your ancestors. You ain't got to believe me. Gentiles will pay for the sins of their ancestors. Joel 3, for behold, in those days and at that time when I shall bring again the captivity of Judah and Jerusalem, I will also gather all nations and will bring them down into the valley of Jehoshaphat and will plead with them there for my people and my heritage Israel, whom they have scattered amongst the nations and parted my land. We've been over this scripture before. Y'all gonna pay not only money, but there's gonna be something up to the horse's bridle. You know what I'm saying? If you know your word. Verse 3, and they have cast lots for my people and have given a boy for a harlot and sold a girl for wine that they might drink. Oh, see, your ancestors set you up. Yeah, you temporarily lived in our house. You temporarily lived in our land and ate our food temporarily. But daddy coming back. And he got a big old sword that's going to come out of his mouth, whereby he destroyed the nations. I'm just saying, that's your Bible. You claim it's your Bible. It's really ours. Joel 3:4-7. So the Most High said, look, how are you going to pay me back for all that you did to my people? How are you going to do that? How are you going to pay me back? He didn't give you a chance, but y'all would not listen. Now, what have you against me, Tyre and Sidon, and all you regions of Philistia? Are you repaying me for something I've done? If you pay me back, I will swiftly and speedily return on your own heads what you have done. You're going to pay for the sins of your ancestors. For you took my silver and my gold and carried off my finest treasures to your temple. So you took God's money. You took my money. When you mess with my money, you mess with my emotions. Come on, y'all know. You sold the people of Judah and Jerusalem to the Greeks that you might send them what? Far from their homeland. Who y'all think that is? See, I'm going to rouse them out of the places to which you sold them, and I will return on your own heads what you have done. So y'all have sent his people into captivity as slaves around the world, and he said that he's going to return everything you did on your own head. What does that mean? Everything that you did. What did you do? I ain't do nothing, Yacoba. I ain't had nothing to do with it, but your ancestors did. You're going to pay for the sins of your ancestors because he visits the sins on the third and fourth generations. I will sell your son. Somebody going into captivity. I'm going to teach y'all something, how they lied to you in Christianity. I'm telling you. I'm going to teach you how they lied to you in Christianity. I will sell your sons and daughters to the people of Judah, and they will sell them to the Sabaeans, a nation far away. Yahuwah has spoken. I didn't say it. Yahuwah said it. He's going to sell your sons and your daughters. But the kids didn't do nothing. So why they got to go into captivity? Because they're paying for the sins of who? Their parents. I'm just saying. You reading it right there. I ain't make it up, did I?
Well, you know, Yacoba, you're misinterpreting that.
Just trying to help. Don't say nobody didn't love you. I'm just trying to help. I'm telling you, I'm trying to do the will of the Father. The Father told us to be a light to the Gentile. And you know, it's sort of like, you always see in the scriptures, you know, y'all help further the affliction. Y'all do what your daddy did. And your daddy did what his grandpappy did, and y'all further the affliction. Y'all ain't innocent yourselves, but I'm just saying, you still paying for all of that your ancestors then piled on y'all. Y'all can't afford it. There's a lot of sins backed up that y'all got to pay a price for. Jeremiah 30, verse 16, therefore all they that devour thee shall be devoured, and all thine adversaries, every one of them, shall go into captivity, and they that spoil thee shall be a spoil, and all that prey upon thee will I give for a prey. I'm going to tell you, there's some deep stuff here. You don't believe me? Therefore, all they that devour thee shall be devoured. I'm going to show you something, and we're going to talk about this as I continue. But keep this in mind. There's principles of the law being applied here. What principles of the law is being applied here, Yacoba? Therefore, all they that devour thee shall what? Be devoured. Can we say an eye for an eye? Oh, well, an eye for an eye, now that's done away with. That don't apply no more, Yacoba. Oh, no, we're going to talk about that. And all thine adversaries, every one of them shall go into captivity. We went into captivity, you shall go into captivity. Come on, eye for an eye. And they that spoil thee shall what? Be a spoil. Can we say an eye for an eye? You spoiled us, we gonna spoil you. I'm just saying, the law is being applied. Yahuwah is still applying his laws. You just ain't know it, because Christianity then told you ain't nothing you gotta do but believe. You ain't gotta repent and restore. See, repentance requires action. True repentance says, look, I'm sorry I stole your candy. Here's your candy back. Oh, I ate your candy. Well, you know what? I can't give you candy back, but you know what? Here's some money for the candy. I'm just saying, come on now. You know that's just. God is a God of what? Justice. He's also a God of what? Judgment. And all that prey upon thee will I give for a prey. Eye for an eye. You preyed on me? I'm going to pray on you. Oh, see, Jacoba, that's Old Testament. That's not what we see in the New Testament, Jacoba. Watch. Oh, we don't. You think we don't? Oh, watch. I'm trying to help somebody. Can't find Israel's enemy. Isaiah 41:11-12. All who rage against you will surely be ashamed and disgraced. Those who oppose you will be as nothing and perish. Though you search for your enemies, you will not find them. Those who wage war against you will be as nothing at all. So the Most High say, look, I'm getting rid of y'all. But he's a loving God. Yes, he is. He gives grace and mercy to the humble, but not to the wicked. Though you search for your enemies, you will not find them. See, this goes back to the whole idea, and I'm going to just add this in there because I feel like it. That Israel is right next door to Egypt. You didn't run away from the Egyptians just to move right next door. I'm just saying, come on. I'm just saying, but I had to say something because it's really foolish, because, you know, I can't believe I ever thought the Middle East was our land. But I digress. I just had to say it. Yah's revenge, Zechariah 2:8. For thus says Yahuwah of hosts, after the glory hath he sent me unto the nations which spoiled you, for he that toucheth you toucheth the apple of his eye. So we talk about this a lot. But y'all thought it was them folks. Y'all thought them folks was his people. Those who touch Israel touch the apple of his eye. Y'all thought it was them folks, but y'all been messing with his people. Y'all been messing with them Negroes. Y'all been deleting them Negroes and discriminating against them Negroes. But I said a queen. I ain't gonna never see the loss of children. Come on now. Is that not what Babylon say? I said, a queen, I ain't never going to jail for deleting them Israelites. We run this show. What you think we're going to do when all this happened? You think we're going to just sit here and let God do what he's going to do? Oh, yeah. You ain't going to have no choice. God didn't declare the end from the beginning. You already lost. You just ain't know it. See, some of y'all don't know what true repentance is. Y'all know what religion is. And y'all want to follow the God that you made up in your mind, or the God that Catholicism has given you, but not the God of the Bible. Because you don't want to look that close. You don't want to see the God of the Bible. After the second exodus, things will change. Now, we're going to talk about this for a second. And I'm going to read this, and then I'm going to go read the whole thing, because timing-wise, I'm going to show you when this is supposed to occur. Because y'all like to throw this in. Jeremiah 31, in those days, people will no longer say the parents have eaten sour grapes and the children's teeth are set on edge. Instead, everyone will die for their own sin. Whoever eats sour grapes, their own teeth will be set on edge. See, Jacoba, we ain't got to pay for nothing. We ain't got to pay for nothing, Jacoba, because you just read it. that they're going to pay for their own sins. You just read it, Jacob. They're going to pay for their own sin. But let's read the whole thing so we can see the timing of this, shall we? Jeremiah 31. At that time, declares Yahuwah, I will be the God of all the families of Israel, and they will be my people. This is what Yahuwah says. So let's start, first of all, who are we talking about here? Are we talking about the world or are we talking about Israel? I'm just saying. Let's just make sure we're clear on who we're talking about. This is what Yahuwah says. The people who survived the sword found favor in the wilderness when Israel went to find rest. Okay, so Israel's going to find rest. They escaped the sword out of Babylon. See, the sword is here now. It's about to fall on you all and on this nation. Then we, the true Israelites, go into the wilderness. Why? So we can find rest. So the timing of this has to do with what? The second Exodus. Oh, I know some of y'all don't know what the second Exodus is. Go watch the other videos then. Yahuwah appeared to us in the past saying, I have loved you with an everlasting love. Therefore, I have drawn you with loving devotion. Who are we talking about here? Israel. Again, I will build you and you will be rebuilt, O virgin. What? Who? Israel. Again, you will take up your tambourines and go out in joyful dancing. Again, you will plant vineyards in the hill of Samaria. The farmers will plant and enjoy the fruit. Why? Because Israel goes back home. Go read Isaiah 60. For there will be a day when watchmen will call out on the hills of Ephraim, arise, let us go up to Zion, to Yahuwah our Elohim, for this is what Yahuwah says. Sing with the joy for Jacob, shout for the foremost of the nations. Make your praise heard and say, Yahuwah save your people, the remnant of Israel. So there's a remnant going to be left after this war that you all starting. Behold, I will bring them from the land of the north and gather them from the farthest part of the earth, including the blind and the lame, expectant mothers and women in labor. They will return as a great assembly. Can we say second Exodus? They will come with weeping. Did not we see that? In Jeremiah 50, Israel leaves what? Crying, right? They will come with weeping, and by their supplication, I will lead them. I will make them walk beside streams of waters on a level path where they will not stumble. For I am Israel's father, and Ephraim is my firstborn. Hear, O nations, the word of Yahuwah, and proclaim it in distant coastlands. The one who scattered Israel will gather them and keep them as a shepherd keeps his flock. For Yahuwah has ransomed Jacob and redeemed him from the hand that had overpowered him. That's you folks. They will come and shout for joy, and on the heights of Zion, they will be radiant over the bounty of Yahuwah. The grain, new wine, and all the young of the flocks and herds, their life will be like a well-watered garden, and never again will they languish. Then the maidens will rejoice with dancing, young men and old as well. I will turn their mourning into joy. Why were they mourning? Because they were held captive. And give them comfort and joy for their sorrow. I will fill the souls of the priests abundantly and will fill my people with my goodness. This is what Yahuwah says. A voice is heard in Ramah, mourning and great weeping, Rachel weeping for her children and refusing to be comforted because there are no more. This is what Yahuwah says. Keep your voice in weeping and your eyes in tears. For the reward for your work will come, declares Yahuwah. Then your children will return from the land of the enemy. Your children will return from the land of the enemy. What enemy? What enemy, family? What enemy, Gentiles? What land is Israel scattered amongst the nations as slaves and going to return back to the land that they were taken from the land of their enemy? So there is hope for your future, declares Yahuwah, and your children will return to what? Their own land. I have surely heard Ephraim's moaning. You discipline me severely like an untrained calf. Restore me and I may return, for you are Yahuwah, my Elohim. After I returned, I repented. And after I was instructed, I struck my thigh in grief. I was ashamed and humiliated because I bore the disgrace of my youth. Is not Ephraim a precious son to me, a delightful child? Though I often speak against him, I still remember him. Therefore, my heart yearns for him. I have great compassion for him. Set up the road marks, establish the signposts, keep the highway in mind, the road you have traveled. Return, O virgin, who? Israel. Return to these cities of yours. How long will you wander, O faithless daughter? For Yahuwah has created a new thing in the land. A woman will shelter a man. This is what Yahuwah of hosts, the Elohim of Israel, says. When I restore them from captivity, what? Because they were slaves. They will once again speak this word in the land of Judah and in its cities. May Yahuwah bless you, O righteous dwelling place, O holy mountain. And Judah and all its cities will dwell together in the land, the farmers and those who move with the flocks. For I will refresh the weary soul and replenish all who are weak. Now we're getting up to where we want to be. As this I awoke and looked around, my sleep had been most pleasant to me. The days are coming, declares Yahuwah, when I will sow the house of Israel and the house of Judah with the seed of man and beast, just as I watched over them, to uproot and tear down, to demolish, destroy, and bring disaster. So I will watch over them to build and to plant, declares Yahuwah. In those days, this is where we're at. It will no longer be said the fathers have eaten sour grapes. What days? The days of the second Exodus. After the second Exodus is when this occurs. The fathers have eaten sour grapes and the teeth of the children are set on edge. Instead, each will die for his own iniquity. If anyone eats the sour grapes, his own teeth will be set on edge. Behold, the days are coming, declares Yahuwah, when I will make a new covenant with the house of Israel and with the house of Judah. When is this? It ain't happened yet. It's at the time of the second Exodus. I just showed you that. Don't tell me that you got to pay for. You don't have to pay for your ancestors' sins yet. That everyone paid for their own sins. No, that's after the second Exodus. See, my question is, do you believe the Bible or not? Do you believe the scriptures or not? Some of y'all don't believe the scriptures. That's obvious. Some of y'all don't believe the scriptures. That's obvious. Galatians 6, 7 and 9. Do not be deceived. Yahuwah cannot be mocked. A man reaps what he sows. A man reaps what he sows. Whoever sows to please their flesh from the flesh will reap destruction. Whoever sows to please the spirit from the spirit will reap eternal life. Let us not become weary in doing good, for at the proper time we will reap a harvest if we do not give up. So, Levi reaped blessings because Abraham paid tithes. Israel went into captivity because their ancestors sinned against the Most High. The Most High says he's going to judge to the third and fourth generation for the sins of the parents. But I know you, Kobo, but that's Old Testament. No. You're going to reap what you sow. That's New Testament. An eye for an eye, a tooth for a tooth. I know you don't believe it. An eye for an eye, a tooth for a tooth still applies. Well, what did Christ mean, Nicole? But we're going to get there. Restoration or captivity. Exodus 22, 1 through 5. 1 through 15. Well, really, 22. Whoever steals an ox or a sheep and slaughters it, or sells it, must pay back 5 head of cattle for the ox and 4 sheep for the sheep. This is law. If a thief is caught breaking in at night and is struck a fatal blow, the defender not guilty of bloodshed, but it But if it happens after sunrise, the defendant is guilty of bloodshed. Now, pay close attention to this. Anyone who steals must certainly make restitution. See, Gentile, we call it reparations. This is the law. Anyone who steals, you stole men, you stole money, you stole lives. Anyone who steals must certainly make restitution, but if they have nothing, they must be sold to pay for their theft. That's why you're going in captivity, because you ain't got enough money. This is why you're going in captivity, because you ain't got enough money. I keep trying to help you. But if they have nothing, they must be sold to pay for their theft. If the stolen animal is found alive in their possession, whether ox or donkey or sheep, they must pay back double. Come on now. They must pay back double. Let me ask the family right quick. Family, what does the Bible say happens to those who then enslaved Israel and persecuted Israel? How much judgment do they get? How much judgment does Babylon get? They must pay back double. You know that's in the book of Revelation, right? Did y'all know that? Curses on Israel's enemies. Deuteronomy 30, verse 7. And Yahuwah, our Elohim, will put all these curses on your foes and enemies who what? Persecute you. Why? Because you reap what you sow. You reap what you sow. All them curses y'all put on us, y'all, all those judgments and persecutions y'all did to us, what? Go to y'all, but times two. You ain't got to believe me. Believe the Bible. Trying to help y'all. Been trying to help y'all. Laws still apply in the New Testament. Now, this is where I got you. This is where I got you. You think you're going to wiggle out? Revelation, New Testament, right? Revelation 13:10. He that leadeth in captivity shall go into captivity. He that killeth with the sword must be killed with the sword. Here's the patience and the faith of the saints. He that leadeth into captivity shall go into captivity. He that killeth with the sword must be killed with the sword. What law is being applied here? What law is being applied here? Can we say an eye for an eye and a tooth for a tooth? Come on. This saying the same thing. Can we say an eye for an eye and a tooth for a tooth? Reward her even as she rewarded you. Double unto her according to her work. Is that not the law? Is that not the law? An eye for an eye, a tooth for a tooth. He that leadeth into captivity, you led us into captivity, shall go into captivity. Eye for an eye. He that killeth with the sword must be killed with the sword. A tooth for a tooth. Come on. An eye for an eye still applies. Leviticus 24, 17 and 22. Whoever takes a human life shall surely be put to death. He who kills with the sword must be killed with the sword. Whoever takes an animal's life shall make it good, life for life. You killed us. Come on now. I'm just saying, eye for an eye, tooth for a tooth. Those who persecuted you shall be persecuted. These curses are going to be on your enemies. They're going to get double of what you got. If anyone injures his neighbor as he has done, it shall be done to him. Fracture for fracture, eye for an eye, tooth for tooth. Whatever injury he has given a person shall be given to him. What? Whatever injury he gave to a person shall be given to him. He that leadeth into captivity shall go into captivity. He that killeth with the sword shall be killed with the sword. Shall we say an eye for an eye, a tooth for a tooth? Whosoever kills an animal shall make it good, and whoever kills a person shall be put to death. You shall have the same rule for the sojourner and for the native, for I am Yahuwah, your Elohim. I told you, God is applying the laws. God is supplying the laws. The laws are not done away with. His laws still stand. That's his will. That's his rules. An eye for an eye, a tooth for a tooth. Well, Yakuba, what does it mean in Matthew 5:38? Matthew 5:38 applies to the brethren and not the wicked. Matthew 5:38, just like the neighbor, you shall love your neighbor. Go read it in Leviticus. It applies to your brothers. Same thing with eye for an eye. It's talking about your brother. Well, how do you know that, Yakuba? Well, let's talk about it. Matthew 5:38, you have heard that it was said, an eye for an eye, a tooth for a tooth. But I tell you to not resist an evil person. If anyone slaps you on the right cheek, turn to them the other cheek also. Well, how do I know that applies to the brethren? Well, we go further up. Let's go further up to Matthew 5:23. Matthew 5:23 said, therefore, if you are offering your gift to the altar and there remember that your brother or your sister has something against you, leave your gift there in front of the altar. First go and be reconciled to them, then come and offer your gift. Go read the laws in Leviticus. You will see same thing with the loving your neighbor is dealing with your brother. Context-wise, eye for an eye is also dealing with your brother, dealing with an Israelite, or dealing with a Gentile believer who has been grafted in. It has nothing to do with the wicked. The law is being applied by Yahuwah. Matthew 5:17, do not think that I have come to abolish the law. See, Gentiles, y'all Christians, y'all be saying, oh, Lord, yes, you did. You say the law done away with. But he just told you, do not think that I've come to abolish the law or the prophets. I've not come to abolish them, but to fulfill them. What does he mean? If he's not abolishing the law, he's applying the law. See, y'all got a problem with the word fulfill. He's applying the law, completing the law. They translated it fulfill. Verse 18, for verily I say unto you, till heaven and earth pass away, one jot or one tittle shall in no wise pass from the law till all be fulfilled. That means till all of them are accomplished, all of it is done, all of it is applied. Until I finish applying these laws. Well, what laws are he applying? Yeah, the sacrificial laws is one of them and the most important. What other laws is he applying? The laws about judging those who take a life. The laws about judging those who steal people and steal their land and steal their wealth. How do I know that? Well, just turn to the book of Revelation. If you turn to the book of Revelation, what would you find? You will find our Savior coming riding on a white horse with his sword in his mouth and his vesture dipped in blood to what? Destroy the nations. And why is he destroying the nations? He already told you for what they've done to his chosen. Go read Joel chapter 3. I'm trying to help you. The sins of the ancestors, you're going to have to carry and pay. Your sins might be forgiven. You might not go to hell. But just as we pay for the sins in this world, on this earth, for the sins, because this is the law, we pay, y'all gonna pay. Why? That a man sowed, that shall he reap. He that's leading the captivity shall go into captivity. He that killeth with the sword must be killed with the sword. An eye for an eye, a tooth for a tooth. I'm just saying. Somebody lied to you. So here's the deal. The laws are not done away with, and the Most High is applying those laws. The Most High is applying those laws. And you all who persecute us today and your ancestors who have persecuted us, some of you Gentiles are going to pay the price for the sins of your ancestors. That's just the way it is. Now, hopefully you don't be the ones to pay the price unto death. Hopefully you live. But some of y'all are going to captivity. You ain't got no more time left. You ain't got to believe me. The Most High didn't do away with the laws. Yeshua say, I didn't come to destroy the laws, but to fulfill them. Not one jot or tittle going to go away. If not one jot or tittle going to go away, it's going to be fulfilled of the law. If not one jot or tittle going to go away, then somebody going in captivity. Somebody going to be paying double. Some people are going to be deleted. Come on. I know you don't get this in your Christian church. I know you don't. They ain't telling you the truth. They want you to feel good while you sitting under judgment and not knowing why. Just like us. We were sitting there, Lord, why do people hate us? Lord, why all the nations hate us? Why, Lord, when we go to Iran, when we go to Bangladesh, when we go to Mexico, when we go to Britain, when we go to France, when we go to all these, why they hate Negroes? What do we do? Lord, we ain't do these people nothing. Why they keep persecuting us? Well, when your people ask why all this evil happening to me, tell them that it was because of the sins of their ancestors. Why? Because the law says that the Most High will visit the sins on the third and the fourth generation. It just so happens that we didn't went into captivity for what? 400 years. And at the end of the fourth generation, or the 400 year, is the end of the curse. We about to go home. We about to be redeemed.
You mean you're not redeemed already, Yacoba?
Well, yes, spiritually, yes. I'm born again. If I die today, by the grace of Yahuwah, I'm going to be by his side. But we still in the land of our captivity. We still held captives until we leave. And the Most High has to judge our enemies. So if not one jot, not one tittle of the law gonna pass away till all be fulfilled, then the law says an eye for an eye, a tooth for a tooth. He that lead into captivity, go into captivity. He that killed with the sword shall be killed with the sword. If not one jot or tittle of the law can be done away with till all be fulfilled, then those who killed with the sword, what? Must be killed with the sword. Those who stole got to pay double. They got to restore. Y'all got to bring us back home. That's in the law. Some of y'all going to have to pay with your existence because that's the law, because you didn't took a life. You got away with it temporarily, but you didn't took a life. Y'all going to lose land, property, family, children because you got to pay for the sins of your ancestors. No, I don't, Yacoba. That's cool. You ain't got to believe me. You ain't got to believe me. The law still applies, but I'm forgiven. Yes, you're forgiven if you're a true believer. The question is if most of y'all are true believers. I'm not convinced. But you're still going to be paying for them sins of your ancestors in the flesh. You still on this earth. Your family has inherited a debt. You got a debt to pay. Well, it's not my debt, Yacoba. I didn't sign the papers for that debt. But your ancestors did. And according to the law, go read your Bible, the children got to pay for it. So if y'all want to support this ministry, you can by becoming a patron. You can also give TEOTW $7101. It would be nice if the many people, I'm not complaining, don't get me wrong. I thank all the ones who support this ministry. But it would be nice for all of you all who learn stuff from here and feel like you've been edified, support this ministry. I'm just saying. There's only a few true supporters of this ministry. But we're going to keep doing what we're doing regardless until the Most High says stop. But understand this. What a man sows, he reaps. That's a law. Don't let nobody lie to you. If you sow good fruit, you're going to reap good fruit. If you sow evil fruit, you're going to reap evil fruit. If you sow good fruit, your children going to reap good fruit. If you sow evil fruit, your children going to reap evil fruit. They're going to inherit that. Just like Levi inherited the good fruit from Abraham. But don't get it twisted. God is not mocked. Don't think because your ancestor then built all his fortune, left all his property and wealth and all his dead bodies, that you get to live in luxury on money that was taken from people that has been deleted. It don't work that way. We're going to end it with this response from this sister. I like, good words. Peace and blessings, Israel. Your captivity is ending.
Good morning, y'all. How y'all doing? Y'all all right? I'm good. Look at here. Mr. Huckleberry said, if God is black, cool, but his own people denied him and sent him to the cross. Embarrassing. I'm telling you what's embarrassing. But let's handle that little first part first. You act like you didn't forget what the Bible said. You know who's in power then, right? Okay. But to the embarrassing part. Okay, so it's cool to his people. I mean, that he black, right? So that means you know that his people black. So who denying him now? Let's be real. Who denying him now? So if he black and his people black, who finna get in trouble for doing his people wrong? Who he coming back for recompense to pay recompense upon? Who he coming back to get? Who he coming back to save? If he coming back to save his people, that means he come back to save us. But if he come back to save us, who he come back to save us from? That means he come back to save us from people like you, then, don't it? The very people who hate his people. The people who have done his people wrong all these years. You reap. You shall reap what you have sown over all these years. Let's talk about that embarrassment. All the things your ancestors done did and all the things y'all continue to do, y'all about to reap that harvest. Yes, it's cool because he come back to save his people. But that blood that's going to be up to the bridal's neck, because if he come to save his people, who the blood belong to? people who did his people wrong you speak. They got a lot of reaping. A lot of reaping. Just think of all them years that y'all ain't never had to pay for what y'all, all the evils y'all done did. Just go back. Hundreds and hundreds and hundreds and hundreds. Just keep going. All the way back to all the people y'all done hurt. Y'all gonna have to reap that harvest. All praises to the Most High for that thing.